May his great riches rest upon us all this great Shabbat, the great day of his visitation. We lay aside his other activities and he enter into the bed of Yisra'el. We may be strengthened and reminded of his magnificent works, the might of his hand, and the power of his majestic tiferah, his beauty, that spans the concept of beauty. We're going to hear from the Achim today. I want to read a few verses before they come. Zakane, YarameYah come. We're going to hear from Zakane, BenAmmiy, and Shimriy. I was thinking that as a young man, I found this scripture 38 years ago. And as I was pondering this morning, I open up to the writings of Eob and also to Helium, the songs of agony and pain, but yet the resolution is great confidence and trust in Almighty Yahweh. There are not many markings in this book, but there are words that I will underline. This morning I have been searching the Torah to see the repulsiveness of my own ignorance and things that I have said and taught to leave Yah's people astray. And I must make amends, as we all must do that, Yisra'el. And it showed me the repulsiveness of my own ignorance and my own folly, the state of my juvenile mind, that we think we know, but we literally do not know. And this is a book that we must search and seek out the very exact detail. He commands us to search the YAHWEH scripture. For in searching that we think we have eternal life, olam vi'ad, chayil. He says, and these are the ones that say they have the edah, testimony of Yahshua HaMashiach. We have lost the way, in a way that is so profound that we don't know how to get back on the way. And I can see as a young man how that I would labor in this book with my strong concordance that I had here for many years. I don't know what happened to it. And I would see the value of one word and the importance, and I would underline that. I would see Allah, who speaks unto Eob. He says, because there is Ebra wrath. He says, I want you to beware, lest he take you away with his stroke. He said, I don't care how rich you are. He said, and there is no great ransom, none whatsoever, that cannot deliver you. I'm so glad because of Yahshua, hallelujah, that he is the great deliverance of the nation. Yisra'el is the one that makes us free, that we are free and free indeed, and that we may understand who he is. Give me a few minutes and that's it. I want the Achim to come and teach and declare his truth. Elihu says this unto Eob, just hear this, and I want to read from Tehillim. He said, understanding, or he used the word touching, opening up your knowledge to him. He says, touching the Almighty, we cannot find him out. He is excellent, superior in power, in great power. This is what I want you to hear here, because I want to read from Tehillim. 30-some years ago, I marked the scripture here. He is excellent in power and in judgment and in plenty of justice. He will not afflict. He will not afflict. We will have the Sarah, the trials. He's plenteous in judgment and in his justice. He will not afflict. Dawid says in Tehillim, he says, consider my affliction, the aggressiveness of my enemies and those that war against the standards. He said, consider me in my Sarah, the great trials and tribulation. Yet this profound Dalmeids, Elihu said to Eob in the midst of the one of the most complex agonies that a man could suffer, that resonate Yeshua and the body, that there shall be great trials and affliction. Many are the affliction of the Sadiq. He said, consider mine affliction. And then he asked Yah to deliver me. Why? He said, in the midst of all of that, Eob did not charge Yah foolishly. He says one thing that we do not meditate on. We don't think. He said, I do not forget your Torah. I do not forget Yahshua. We forget him in the midst of our delusional state of uncomfort. He said, I do not forget, forsake, go astray, go away from your Torah. He said, plead my cause and deliver me quick and make me alive according to your word. He says, your Yeshach, or your Yoshua, your Yeshua, he said, your salvation is far from the wicked. He said, I can't even call upon you if I was a wicked man. I'm trusting you. He said, your Yoshua, your Yeshua, your salvation is far from the wicked. He said, for they seek not the pikud, the statutes, the wisdom of Yah's mind. What are we seeking today? Nothing satisfies this generation. He says, great is your chesed, your great tender kindness, your love for me. And then he says this, make me alive. Make me alive according to your judgments. That's why Elihu said that the judgments of Yah, your rights, make me right, make me, quicken me according to your judgment. That's how he makes us alive, that we know that he's correcting us and judging us. He said, many are my persecutors and mine enemies, yet I do not for one second forget, decline my heart from your edoth, your testimonies. They're true. They're powerful. I turn to the record in my heart that my avat placed in there by the teaching as I watch him in the gate of Yerushalayim and declare and cry of the excellence of my Abba. I beheld those that transgress and it troubled me. We see those that lie and cheat and steal, and it doesn't trouble us, and it should. He says, I saw them do those wicked things, and it troubled me, because they did not shema, they kept not your Torah, your Daba, your Dabarim, your promises, your words. They didn't keep that. He said, Yah, consider how much I achava, how much I love, how much I desire your precepts. Make me alive O Yahweh, according to your hasets, your great love, kindness, your tenderness. He said, this is my testimony. He said that your word, Yahweh, your dabarim, your promises, he said your word is true. It is amen. It is faithful. It is steadfast. It is true. Your word is true. From the Bereshit, from the beginning. And every what of your Sadiq, Mishrachim, every one of your righteous judgments endures forever. He's not changing anything for you. He's not going to alter the process for any of us. Every one of his righteous judgments, every one of them, they are forever. They're not going to change. He's not going to alter it for you, your mama, your daddy, your grandpappy, and your grandmammy either. That's a fact. He said, those in high positions have persecuted me without a cause. We all believe that we have been done wrong without any cause. He said, but my love, it means nothing to me. I read it as it is stated here. He says, but my heart stand in awe of your words. Nothing else subdue me. He said, of all that the great powers and rulers can do to me, my heart, my love, my labor stands with amazement at the power of Yahshua HaMashiach. We have lost it. We are a weak and beggary people. We don't care about each other. We don't give a damn. We don't even know how to consider one another. We're false. We're disingenuous. We're not real. We're pretenders. And we don't want to deal with that. It is right, old woman. He says, I rejoice. Now, how many of us truly rejoice at his words? As one that finds the great riches of the spoil. What word is judgment? He said, I hate, I shone, I despise the lying tongue. The tongue that lies, I hate it. We don't hate lying tongues. I have put together quite a few messages this week. One this morning that is beyond my ability to understand. But I understand because I labor on each word tremendously, aggressively. And I search the whole book. I search the whole book. I do. You love reading books. I don't read books. I recall, let me say this, and Zakane is coming to bring the brothers. I recall that as I would read, I would try to read one book a week. And this woman at the job I worked, she thought she was intelligent, she was a bright. She was this kind of portly, you know, disfigured woman. She was very unattractive. She come to me, guess what I went last night? I went to this seminar that talks about how you just can't judge or perceive one by the outward appearance. She said, it was so amazing, read this. So she gave me this thing that would took the average person 10, 15 minutes to read. At that time, I taught myself the form of my own speed reading. So I read the thing in about a minute. She looks at me and say, you haven't read that. And I began to tell everything that was in the booklet. She said, this is what this was all about that I went to. I perceive that you had not even given it attention. Woman, you don't know I read all the time. It doesn't mean anything. But this book, Dawid didn't say, I love to read the philosophical ideas of man. He says, I hate the lying tongue, but your Torah do I love. I love your Torah. He says, seven times a day do I praise you because of what? Your righteous judgment. We hate judgment. We don't want any kind of judgment. No man wants to be judged. No wife wants to be told. No husband wants to be corrected. No child wants to be corrected. That's how wicked we are. You don't give a damn. You talking about you love. Now that's how this man in the midst of his great agony talking about judgment. The mishpatim. It's amazing how women think and men think. Women will leave their husbands because they don't want him to judge them. And he is the yoshach of their home. And they're lying of horrible ways to talk to their mind. He says, great Gadol Shalom, have they all which love your Torah, and nothing shall offend them. One more I want to read. Nothing is going to offend us. Hallelujah. He says, and nothing shall offend them. And then he says, he addressed him by his name, Yahweh, I have tikvah for your salvation, and I have done your mitzvot. I've done your commandments. This is a lion generation. Come on, Zakane. They don't give a damn about Yah. And that's a fact. I don't care if you don't love me. I'm not fearful of this wicked generation. And it makes no difference what you think or what you say. That's a fact. Yabrak Shalom.
Hallelujah. Due to the Yahweh for this beautiful Yom, this day has given us Yisrael. We're going to hear today from our Zakane BenAmmiy Labash and our Ox Shimriy. I do want to read this in Tehillim 77 before I bring Zakane BenAmmiy up, because this is what Yahweh desires for his house. This is his way. This is his tough pleasure that we assemble together, whether you're on radio, as a body, as one, that we may hear the wonderful Torah, the mitzvah of Almighty Yahweh. And we shall hear that from our Akim on this day. Hallelujah. It says here in Tehillim 77, just a few verses quickly. He said, I cry unto Yah with my voice, even unto Yahweh with my voice. And he gave his ear unto me. He said, in the day of my trouble, I sought Yahweh. He said that my sore ran in the night, and it ceased not. He said that my nephesh refused to be comforted. But he said, I Zakar, I remember Almighty Yahweh, and I was troubled. He said, I complained, and my ruach was overwhelmed, Salah. But listen to what he says here, Yisrael. He did not doubt Yahweh in anything. He said, you hold my eyes awake. He said, I am so troubled that I cannot speak. He says in verse 5 that I have considered the days of old. He knew that Yahweh had not forsaken him. Yahweh had not left him by the wayside. Why? Because he's Zakar. He remembered the days of old, the works of Almighty Yahweh. And he said, in the years of ancient times. He said, I call to remembrance my song in the night. He said, I continue with my own left, and my ruach made diligent search. He searched his left. He searched his heart. And he says this in verse 7. He said, will Yahweh cast off forever? And will he be favorable no more? His hasid, is it clean or is it gone forever? And does his promises fail forevermore? Does his promises fail, Yisrael? They do not fall. It says in verse 9 that hath Yahweh forgotten to be compassionate unto me? And in his anger has he shut up his tender hasid, Shalah. In verse 10, he says this before Zakane comes up, Zakane BenAmmiy. He said, I said, this is my infirmity, but I will remember of the right hand of Almighty Yahweh of Most High. And he said, I will remember the works of Almighty Yahweh, and surely I will Zakar remember the works of old. And I will meditate of his works, and I will talk about his doings. verse 13. He says, your way, Yahweh, your way. Not our way, not our path, what we desire. But he said, Yahweh, this is your way. He says, your way, Yahweh, is in your bayat. It's in the assembly. It's in the gathering together. Torah said, where there is wisdom, where there's hukmah, there is safety. This is Yahweh's way, that we gather, that we assemble together, Yisrael, Yah, that we may hear of the wonderful works of Almighty Yahweh. Even as Dawid, through his trials and his tribulations, understood this, that he will find comfort, that he will find the judgment of Almighty Yahweh, he will find happiness and completeness in the tabernacle, in the assembly. Hallelujah. So we're going to ask Zakane BenAmmiy, as if he would, to come on up and present us with the wonderful works and words of Almighty Yahweh. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, Yah's Tov, Yisrael. He brought us to see another Sabbaton. And brought us into the bed once again, Yisrael. For Yisrael, we must continue. Continue where? In the way, Yisrael. We know, Yisrael, that when the runners in a race, that they cannot bear off and go another direction to win the race. But they must stay in the way of the rest of the runners if they want to win the race, Yisrael. Well, let us see what the meaning of this word, continue, Yisrael. Continue, say, it says, to fulfill, to keep, Yisrael, and then to prepare, and then to perform, to stand. Take one stand to be in a standing attitude, Yisrael. Always being on guard for the fruitful and the wickedness of darkness, Yisrael. To stand forth, take a stand, present oneself to attend upon, to be and to become a servant of, Yisrael. To hold one ground, remaining standing, Yisrael. Whatever come against you, Yisrael. And then it says, Brother Shaul, as he tells us in Philippians 1 and 21, for to me is live, Yisrael, and Yeshua HaMashiach to die is gain, Yisrael. Ain't it worth to stand, Yisrael? And it goes on to say, even a little farther, Philippians 1 and 22, but if I live in this body of flesh, this is the fruit of my labor, Yisrael. Yet I shall choose. I do not know, Yisrael. And then it goes on, Philippians, to tell us, for I am torn between two desires. And we are torn today, Yisrael, between two desires. Desire to walk in this Torah and desire the things of this life, this world, Yisrael, which have no strength to keep us in this walk of Abba Yahweh, Yisrael. And it goes on, as I read a little further, it says, nevertheless, to abide in this body of flesh is more needful for you, Yisrael, to show Yisrael that as Yahshua HaMashiach, as he walked and was tested in every test that we got to go through, but still he trusted in the Torah to get the victory, Yisrael. Philippians 1 and 25. Having this confidence, I know Yisrael. I know Yisrael. That I shall stay here for now and continue and to prepare Yisrael with you all for your progress and the joy of Emunah, Yisrael. This is what I'm going to teach this evening, Yisrael. It tells us in Philippians, for let us continue with Yah Yisrael, that your boast and rejoicing may be of more abundantly, Yisrael, in Yahshua, no one else, HaMashiach. For me, by my coming, you gain, Yisrael. Again, he's coming. He's coming again. For we're going, Yisrael, to continue, Yisrael. When the people, Yisrael, got what they wanted, why did they get what they wanted? Because they continue in the way, Yisrael. And we will see when you're in the way, Yisrael, how Yah will barak you, Yisrael. And Matthew was tell us right here in 15 and 30, and great multitudes came to Yahshua, having with them that were lame, blind, dumb, maimed, and many others, Yisrael, and cast them down at Yahshua's feet. And what did he do, Yisrael? It said he healed them, Yisrael. Oh, speak on to us, Father. Matthew 15 and 31. Is so much that the multitude wondered when they saw the dumb to speak. What power do this man have that when a man had not talked for so many years and he made him to speak? And then to go on further, there was another one that they had trouble believing in the first. He said the man he made whole. Make us whole today, Yahweh, in the mind of your Torah. And then he said he made the lame to walk, Yisrael, and the blind to see. Anoint our eyes today, Yisrael, that we may see as your Torah go forth to us today. And they gave honor and praise to Yahweh of Yisrael. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Because he will open my eyes today, and he will make us see Yisrael. Oh, he will make the deaf ears to hear of what's being spoken to strengthen Yisrael today. Matthew 15 and 32 say, then Yahshua called to his disciple and said, I have compassion. Oh, he have compassion on us today, Yisrael. On the multitude. Why, Abba Yahweh? Because they continue with me. And now 3 days. And have nothing to eat. And we will be fed today, Yisrael. And I will send them away. Fast not fasting, lest they not faint not. In the way, Yisrael, and he will feed us today. At least we not get weary, and we faint, Yisrael, but we continue in the way, Yisrael, in Yahshua, Yisrael, for we must continue in the way, Yisrael, oh, Yisrael. And here, Yisrael, is one more thing, Yisrael, as I speak to the house, that we must continue. For Hannah had a prayer, Yisrael. And Samuel 1 and 9, Hannah rose up early after they had eaten in Shiloh And after they had drunk, now Eli the Kohen sat upon a seat by a post of the great tabernacle of Yahweh. Pray on, Anna. And she was in bitterness of her nephesh and prayed to Yahweh and wept sore, Yisrael. And she vowed a vow. And many vows we have vowed, Yisrael, but have not kept. And said, O Yahweh of hosts, if you will indeed pray on, Anna, and look on the affliction of your handmaid. And as she said, Abba Yahweh, I pray the same thing. Remember me, Abba Yahweh, and not forget your handmaid. But will you give to your handmaid a man child? And then I will give him to you, Yahweh, all the days of my life. Oh, you listen to this prayer, Yisrael. And they shall no razor come upon his head. And then it goes on in Samuel to tell us. And it came to pass, as she continued praying before Yahweh, that Eli marked her mouth, Yisrael. Don't worry as you give it to Yahweh. Or when you're praying, Yisrael, don't worry what nobody think, Yisrael. You just keep on talking to Yah, Yisrael. And then it goes on to say, 1 Samuel 1 and 13, now Hannah, she spoke in her lab, Yisrael. And she opened up her lips and moved, but her voice was not heard. Therefore, Eli thought that she had been drunken, Yisrael. Oh, but she wasn't, Yisrael. But her leg was true to Abba Yahweh. And Yisrael, as Hannah prayed, there's a prayer to Yahweh that we should pray, Yisrael. Let that we tell us, Yisrael. In Tehillim 36 and 9. For with few, Yah, is the fountain of life. For you, Yah, is your light of Yahshua. Through Yahshua, we shall see light. As we continue in his Torah, Yisrael, and Brother Dawid said in 36 and 10, oh, continue. Faint not, Yisrael. Your steadfastness, oh, and your hava, and your loving kindness to them that know you, and your tzedakah to the upright, Yisrael. In your lev, Yisrael. For his name, Yisrael, we must continue and we must walk in Yahshua's precious name, Yisrael. Tehillim 72 and 17 tell us, for it's only one name, Yisrael, that endureth forever, Yisrael. His name shall be continue. It said continue. As long as the sun that he put up above us, Yisrael, and men shall be baraked in him, Yisrael, and all, Yisrael, his nation, all, Yisrael, his nation, shall call him, oh, for they know him, Yisrael, shall call him Barak, Yisrael. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We must, Yisrael, continue in the truth as long as his name, Yisrael. But Yahshua he continued to pray, YarameYah. Let me read, because we must do the same, YarameYah. That is what Yahweh wants us to do. Luke 6 and 12 said, and it came to pass in those days that he went out into the mountain to pray. And he continued all night in prayer to Yahweh. It's been a long time, YarameYah, since I prayed all night to Yah. But listen to what he say, that when you just stay there a while, he said in Luke 6 and 13, when it was day, he called to his disciples, and of them, YarameYah, he chose 12. But he chose 12, YarameYah, whom he also named apostles. But he prayed all night, YarameYah, to get the confirmation, YarameYah. Yeshua prayed all night continually, YarameYah, before he picked his people. Sometimes it takes praying all night, YarameYah, before we can get the victory, YarameYah. Oh, YarameYah, for the great victory of Emunah, YarameYah, for we continue in Yahweh. Yahweh tells us, YarameYah, David is still talking to us, YarameYah, in Tehillim Psalm 119 and 90, it says this, your faithfulness is to all generation. And you have established your land, and it abides. Oh, speak to us that way. For why they continue this day according to your orders. For all are your servants, and we are all our servants unto Yah, YarameYah. Well, we must continue in the way, YarameYah. For there are no shortcuts, YarameYah. There's only one way, YarameYah. And we know that the scriptures say, here is the way, and we must come in at the door, YarameYah. Psalm 119 and 92 say, unless your Torah, unless, YarameYah, this Torah that we were here today, has been our delight, YarameYah. I know the word said my delight, but has it been our delight as we're here today, YarameYah? I should then have perished in my affliction, YarameYah. In 119 and 93 said, I will never forget, oh yeah, your precepts, your covenant, yeah. Your Torah that you have gave us, a guide to stay in the way. For with them, you have quickened me, Abba Yahweh. For we must, YarameYah, continue in this wisdom of Abba Yahweh. And Shirak tells us about this wisdom. It says in 1 and 14, for the fear, YarameYah, oh, yes. Oh, help me, Yah, is the beginning of wisdom. And it was created with the faithfulness in the womb, YarameYah. But YarameYah, Shirak 1 and 15 said, she has built an everlasting foundation with men, and she shall continue with their seed, YarameYah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. 1 and 16 said, but to the fear, Yahweh is fulfillness of wisdom, YarameYah. Not only that, YarameYah, it says she fills and satisfies men with her fruits, YarameYah. Oh, yes, she do, Yisrael. For Yisrael, for we want Yisrael to continue Yisrael in this world. And in Yah's Torah, Yisrael. Let me read on a little farther, Yisrael. Oh, Brother Dawid, is not through with us yet. Psalm 36 and 7 said, how excellent, Yisrael, is your steadfastness and your love kindness, Abba Yahweh, toward your people. It said, therefore, the children of Ben-Adam, because of them knowing of they have one, a Torah that they can abide by, and that will keep them in the way, and will take them on through of this journey we own. He said, because of Ben-Adam, put their trust, oh, Torah, Abba Yahweh, under the shadows. Oh, I ain't talking about the shadows we walk it be with us. But he said the shadows of the mighty, of your wings, Abba Yahweh. Oh, up under them wings. We don't have to worry. Tehillim, Psalm 36 and 8. They shall be abundantly, not just a little, not just half, but they shall be abundantly satisfied with the fatness of your house. Oh, he's not through with us yet. He goes on to tell us, you shall make them, oh, Abba Yahweh, hallelujah, make us, Abba Yahweh, them to drink of the rivers of your pleasure, Abba Yahweh. Oh, feed us and give us a drink today, Abba Yahweh. Oh, Psalm 36 and 9 say, for with you, no other one, is the fountain of life. Your light, Yahshua, shall we see, or we continue in the way, Yisrael. Tehillim, Psalm 36 and 10 says, for continue, Yisrael, your steadfastness and love kindness to them that know you. Yes, Yisrael. But Yisrael, it goes on to tell us in Yochanan 2 and 24, for as for you that stay in which you have heard from the beginning, for if that what you have heard from the beginning shall remain in you, you shall also continue in Yahshua HaMashiach. And not only in Yahshua HaMashiach, Yisrael, but in Abba Yahweh. Oh, John, Brother John, and that this is the promise that Yah has promised us. He has promised us, Yisrael, not to forsake us, or not to turn us away, Yisrael. But he has promised us eternal life, Yisrael. But only Yisrael, or we continue in the way, Yisrael. But Yisrael, we cannot only, Yisrael, be a hearer, Yisrael. But we must be a doer also, Yisrael. We must continue of what we hear. But not only hear, Yisrael, we must do, Yisrael. Yaakov, James, oh, speak to James 1 and 22. But it says, but be a doer of this world, Yisrael, not continuing in the way of the Torah, not hearers only, deceiving our own selves, Yisrael, that we're walking according to Yah's Torah, Yisrael, but still having a mind of this world, They had been rooted out of us, Yisrael. Yaakov, James 1 and 23. For it tells us, for if any be a hearer of the word, not a doer, Yisrael, oh, make it plain to us, James. He is like to a man beholding his natural face on the glass, Yisrael. And James goes on to tell us he's not through for shit. For he beholds himself and goes his way. And straightway, Yisrael, oh, and so many times, Yisrael, that we go that way, Yisrael. We forget, Yisrael. But let us see Mark today, Yisrael. Let us hear, Yisrael, that we continue on the way. Oh, it's the mode that go on with that forget, Yisrael. It's that forget what manner of man he was, Yisrael. Forget, Yisrael, that his being a child of Abba Yahweh. And not continuing in the way, Yisrael. He goes straightway, Yisrael, of the things of this flesh, Yisrael. His mind goes to the things of this earthly world. And then it goes on to say in James 1 and 25, but whoso looks, Yisrael, into this perfect, Yisrael, no fault, Yisrael, no lies, Yisrael, but look into the perfect Torah of liberty, Yisrael. And if you continue in the way, Yisrael, it will make you free, Yisrael. It will deliver you, Yisrael, from the fruit of darkness, Yisrael. It will put you, Yisrael, on the way that Yah intends for you to go to an end, Yisrael. Oh, continue on the way, Yisrael. And continue therein, as the words say, he being not a forgetful hearer, Yisrael, but a doer, as Yah have commanded us to do, of Yah's work, Yisrael. This man, Yisrael, this man, Yisrael, shall be, Yisrael, oh, Yisrael, he said, Barak. And not only Barak, Yisrael, he said, Barak indeed, Yisrael. Yeah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yeah. Oh, thank you, Yah. Oh, if I need this today, Yah. Oh, listen, Yisrael. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
We must continue, Yisrael. Yeah. And I will read, Yisrael. Yeah. We must continue in the way. Because there is no other way, Yisrael. Yeah. Only one, Yisrael, for he is the way. And it says in Timothy, 2 Timothy 3 and 13, we must continue in the way, Yisrael, the Torah way, because it tells us of the reason. It said in Timothy 3 and 13, it said, but evil man, and seducer, Yisrael, that is why we must continue in the way, shall wax worse and worse, Yisrael, deceiving, Yisrael, oh, total, that we have one, Yisrael, that we have men that's walking in the way, that can show us, Yisrael, that can identify Yisrael, all them evil mans, Yisrael, and them seducers that try to seduce the people of Yah and try to turn them away from the way, Yisrael, try to turn them away from Torah's way. Oh, total Yah for that. That they're standing steadfast. And why do they show us the way? Because, Yisrael, as Yah say, have not loved kindness towards Yah's people. They don't want them to follow Yisrael. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Timothy 3:14. But continue in the thing which you have learned, Yisrael, and has been assured of knowing, for whom you have learned them, Yisrael. And then it goes on to say in Timothy 3:15, yes, that from a child you have known the Kekfei, Yisrael, yes, Hakadosh, which are able to make you wise, Yisrael, if you continue in the way, Yisrael, through the Emuna, which is the only one, Yisrael, Yahshua HaMashiach, Yisrael. Oh, yes, Yisrael. 2 Timothy 3:16. For all Yisrael, all scriptures, is given not by man, but all scriptures are given by the inspiration of Yahweh. And it is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction to Yisrael. And not only for correction, but for instruction, that we may walk in the way, Yisrael, that we may stay and continue in the way in Siddiqui, Yisrael. Told you, Abba Yahweh, for your reproof, for your correction, and for your instruction. Timothy 3:17, that the man of Yahweh may be perfect if you continue in the way, Yisrael. If you continue in Yah's Torah way, Yisrael, we may be made perfect into that perfect man. Thoroughly furnished, having all the armor that we need, Yisrael, to all to Miss Fox, Yisrael. Oh, let us continue in the way, Yisrael. Let us not walk or try to seek no other way, Yisrael, but only the Torah way, Yisrael, is the way that keeps Yah's people, Yisrael. For there are many avenues and there are many ways that the enemy put out there. But Yah only have one way, and that's Yah's Torah way. Timothy, Timothy 14, 13 say, till I come, and Yahshua is coming, Yisrael. Don't let nobody tell you no different. Let us give tenants to reading, Yisrael, to exhortation and doctrine, Yisrael, of Yah's Torah, Yisrael, that we may hear, Yisrael, or they may enter into our labar, Yisrael, and change the slave of ours, Yisrael, that we walk into that perfect man of Yahshua HaMashiach, Yisrael. And if we continue in the way, it can be so, Yisrael. Timothy 4:14. Neglect not the gift that is in you, Yisrael, which was given you by prophecy, with the laying on of hands of the estate of the elders, Yisrael. And we all, Yisrael, have a gift, Yisrael. And it can be manifested, Yisrael, if we continue in the way and let that way change the land that is in us, that we will walk according to Yah's Torah, Yisrael. It said in Timothy 4:15, it says, meditate upon these things, Yisrael, that we hear that's going to be spoken today, Israel. To the house, Israel. Let it not go in one ear and out the other, Israel. Because it is far to keep us in the way. It is for to show us how far that we are from the way, Israel. Total Yahweh is a harbor that he gives us Melikim to speak to us, to show us how to get back to the way, Israel. Or the way to the kingdom, Israel. For time is so short. And the scripture says, closer than that we realize, Israel. So Torah Yah, as we being fed today, to bring me back into the way. Because I need to be into the way, Israel. Because there's no one but one way. Because it tells us in Timothy 4:16, take heed to yourselves, Israel. Not taking heed to another, Israel. But take heed to yourself, Israel. It's to work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. But we so much, Israel. To be honest with me, Israel. I take heed to my brother, not to myself. I can show him how to continue in the way, but I know I'm walking in the way, Israel. For the correction is not for me. Forgive me, Yah. Because I want to make sure I'm walking in the way before I speak a word to my brother. And don't you know, even so, Israel, the word that we speak, Israel, that they gonna judge you by the way to walk, the way you walk, and the way you talk, Israel. Because if you're not continuing the way, Israel, it will be seen, Israel. And to the doctrine, continue in them. For in doing this, you shall deliver both yourself and to them that hear you, Israel. For if you continue in the way, Israel, you can help someone else, Israel. For if you continue in the way, Israel, someone can come to you, Abba Yahweh, to help them out, Israel. Because truly, Israel, the harbor, Israel, that we have, according to Abba Yahweh and his Torah, we should have toward one another, Israel. That we continue in this walk, we should want our and our hope continue in that same walk, Israel. Oh, precious Abba Yahweh, Torah today, to give us a word, Israel, to continue in the way, Israel. For we got to continue in Yah's truth, Israel. In Yahshua HaMashiach, Israel. We got to stay in the way of Yah's Torah. No matter how it reproves us, no matter how it corrects us, no matter how it show me, myself. I can't point a finger to my ark or my hope, but I got to turn it toward me, Israel. Because this truth is for me. It says to the labor first. But even if I was sitting down there with y'all, Israel, it's still to me, Israel. And I told y'all today, Abba Yahweh, for this precious word of continue in the way. Because we have to continue in the way. For there is no other way. There is no shortcut. Abba Yahweh told us if we tried to go any other way, or we tried to enter in any other way, outside the Torah way, it said that we as a thief and a robber, Yisrael. So Yisrael, Yah, let us continue in the way and let us walk only in that one way, Yah's Torah way. Yisrael, Yah. Zakane, YarameYah, come forth. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
So do y'all. Do y'all for that beautiful word from Isaiah Cain concerning continue, Yisrael, Yah, because we must continue in this path, in this way. We cannot give up. It brings my mind to a marathon. When the runners, they go out to run, sometimes there's only a few, sometimes there are hundreds of people. And even to those last few that try to endure, they endure to the end of that race. Most of the pomp, the gala, of the event has already gone. Those that someone has come in first have already have gone. But that one's mind is set just to finish the course. It's not how fast they get there, but to complete what they had started to do. As it says in Ecclesiastes, that this race is not given to the swift nor to the strong, but as we heard from our Zakane BenAmmiy Bash, but those that endure, those that continue unto the end. Hallelujah. Even those the same shall be Yashak. So we must continue, Yisrael. No matter what comes our way, no matter what obstacles persist us or stand in our path, we must continue. Hallelujah. And all the way to continue that is to walk in the Torah, the Mishvah of Almighty Yahweh. Hallelujah. So we're going to ask that our precious Ark, Shimri, he will come on and continue in this path. Hallelujah. To instruct, to teach, to rebuke, and to correct us, Yisrael, Yah, that we may continue, hallelujah, in the ways of Almighty Yah. Hallelujah.
Ah, yes, Toda Yah. For as our precious Zakane BenAmmiy has told us, that we must, as a people, we must continue in the way as a people of Yah. That is the only way that we will make it. That's the only way that we shall endure is that we continue without any hesitation, without any doubts, without any fears. We must continue in the way. As the people of Yah, we must continue in the way. And how shall we continue in that way, conditions of Yah? How shall we continue? As Zakane BenAmmiy told us, we must rely upon Almighty Yah. But there's one thing that I want to talk on today is the way. What is that way that we must continue in as the people of Yah? It must be a way of Almighty Yah, a way of truth, a way of realness, a way of soberness. Hallelujah. And as I begin and as I proceed within this teaching, we shall understand that even more. Hallelujah. We shall understand, what is this way? What is this way that we as the people of Yah should continue in? What is this way? Hallelujah. Because we as a people, I know that I miss this way. I don't meet up to what this book says as a requirement of continuing in the way of Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. So there is a way, as one of my favorite scriptures, there is a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof is destruction. That's what the book says. The end thereof is destruction, because what? It seems to be right. There's no truth to it. Hallelujah. There's no truth to it. It pleases the flesh. It seems to be right. Why? Because everyone else is doing it. Everyone else is going about that way. It seems to be right, but it's not right. It's the way our minds have been formed from this wicked old land. It seems to be right. But there's a way, as we as the people of Yah, that we must find out. We must find out this way. And it's right here in the book. It's in the Torah. And we must find this way, conditions of Yah. Because if we don't, we will not receive the promises of Almighty Yah. We won't receive those promises. Hallelujah. This is what we all must do. Yahweh is speaking here in Jeremiah 7 and 21. It says, thus saith Yahweh of hosts, the servant master of Israel, put your burnt offerings to your sacrifices and eat flesh. And it goes on to say, it says, for I spoke not to your fathers, nor commanded them in the day that I brought them out of the land of Egypt, Mizraim, concerning burnt offerings or sacrifices. It says, but this word commanded I them, saying, obey my voice.
Yes, he did.
And that's what we must do. Yes. That's how we get in this way of Almighty Yah. Yes. We obey his voice. Yes. We obey his word. We obey his Torah. Not what we conjure up in our minds. Not what we think we know. Not what we read in some book someone else wrote. But what's in this book. This is the voice right here. Hallelujah. This is the voice that we must abide by in order to be in this way of Almighty Yah. It says, and I will be your Abba. Do we hear that, conditions? He says he will be our Abba if we abide, if we listen unto his voice. Hallelujah. That's all we need to do. Abide within his word. Listen to his voice. Not to what we think is right. Hallelujah. But according to what his word says here, it says, and you shall be my people and walk you in all the ways that I have commanded you. He's given us his commandments. They're right here. It says, I'm your Abba. You shall not have no gods before me. Hallelujah. And it says, you shall not make any graven image. And it says, you shall bring the name of your Abba to Shav, for we'll not hold him guiltless that bring his name to Shav. And it goes on to say, remember the Shabbat to keep it Kodesh, Barat, the Shabbat, the day, and set apart. And it says, honor your Abba and your Ima. And it says, you shall not murder, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbors. That is the foundation. What we must base this way of Yah on. And it's simple and plain. It's all covered in here. It's all covered. And this is an extension of that. The word of Yah. It bags it all up. Hallelujah. It bags up every bit of it. Hallelujah. And it goes on to say that it may be well with you. Hallelujah. When we're in the way of Yah, when we're walking in the way of Yah, it's well with us. We're not worried about the small situations that Satan brings to our mind. Well, this one is doing that. This is what's happening. Because it's well with us. Our minds are in tune with Yah. We're in the way. We're not taken by the penny ante things of what Satan brings to us. We're people of strength. We're true conditions. We're true ox. We're true whole kings. Hallelujah. That's when you know that you're in the way. There's a pure fellowship. Hallelujah. This is a pure walk. This is a pure walk. It is nothing fake or phony about this walk in Almighty Yah. And as I go on, you shall see what I'm saying. That this is a pure walk. You're going to see it by your ponim. You're going to see it by your actions. Hallelujah. That's how you know that you're in this way. I mean, we can talk this, as we've heard before, we can talk this talk all you want, but it's by your actions. Hallelujah. It's by your conversation. It's by your hava one towards the other. That's how you know that you're in this way. That's how we know that we are continuing, as Zakane BenAmmiy told us, in the way. Hallelujah. There's no respect of person. There's no favorites. Hallelujah. We fellowship with all, one with the other. Hallelujah. It's equal around the board. Hallelujah. It's equal. Hallelujah. You enjoy being with this one the same way you enjoy being with the other. That's the way. Hallelujah. This is the way of Almighty God. This is what we as a people have to get to be this family that Yah is pleased with, that sends up the sweet-smelling Savior of Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. Because if we're not in this way, we're in the same way of the world. Do not the world just stay with the ones that they like? Do not they be around the ones that they redeem to be high? Those are the ways of the world. This is not of Almighty Yah. But we must stay in this way. Hallelujah. The Ahava one the other. With the true Ahava of Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. But the first things that we must do to stay in this way, because this way, it's a straight way. It's not broad. It's narrow. It's a straight path. Hallelujah. And it says, I'm going to Matthew 7 and 13 and 14. It says, enter you in at the straight gate. For wide is the gate and broad is the way that leads to destruction. So if this gate is straight, we use the term a straight edge razor. When you use a straight edge razor, it gets everything. It leaves nothing. Hallelujah. And that's what this word of Yah does. It's a straight edge razor. Hallelujah. And we got to have this word of Yah within us as a straight edge razor. Well, we're not holding on to nothing. It's cutting off all this kinsmanship of our families and all the other things that hinder us from serving Almighty Yah with the whole lev, with the true lev. Hallelujah. It's like a straight-edged razor. That's what this word is. And it keeps us in the way. It keeps us straight. It keeps us clean. It keeps us shaved from these things that try to bombard us, that try to take hold of our minds. Hallelujah. It says, wide is the gate and broad is the way that leads to destruction. And many there be which go in thereat. Many. Do we not see that in the world today? That there's many. They're trying all different kind of ways to say that they're going into the Shemayams. And it's not true. All different types of religions. And they all supposed to be right. There are many ways. And they're ways of the flesh. So they don't have to give up anything. Hallelujah. They don't want to give up nothing. They don't want to deny themselves. As the Torah tells us as the people. Come out from among them. Be ye separate. They don't want to do that. So that's why we have so many different little religions. So many different little churches here. Churches there. Because they want to take one little thing and run with it. Hallelujah. No one wants the truth today. You all that listen out there live, listen on the live stream, you know this is right. This is the word of Yah. No one wants the truth today. No one wants to hear the truth. No one wants to see themselves. No one wants to enter in at that straight gate. They want to take this one with them or do this or do that. And that's not of Yah. It's a straight edge razor. It cuts all those things off. It makes your heart fat. It makes you happy to be around another conditions. Hallelujah. It makes you want to rub up against them. That's the way of Yah. It's not moody. It's not sometimey. Hallelujah. It's not one day this way and 5 minutes later this way because of a comment. This is the way of Yah. It's faithful. It's true. It's pure. It maintains. Hallelujah. It's level. Hallelujah. This is the word of Yah. This is what he wants for his people. And I know I miss it. And you all miss it also. Hallelujah. Toda Yah. Hallelujah. It says that it may be well with you. And we must, as a people, we must keep the truth. We must keep it. We must guard this truth in order to stay in this way, goodness of Yah. I'm going to give you one reason here in Genesis 3 and 24. It says, so he drove out Adam, and he placed cherubims at the east of the Garden of Eden, and a flaming sword which turned every way. And we know what the Torah talks about, a sword. It says, Yah's word is a two-edged sword. Hallelujah. Yah's word is a two-edged sword. And that's what the word does. It guards us if we keep it within us. It keeps us in the way. Yah placed that sword there. Hallelujah. To keep them out. Because they had gone out of the way. They had gone out of the way. We know the story. Adam had hearkened unto his Isha. He listened unto her. He didn't guard his house as a man. He didn't have the strength that he should have had. Hallelujah. And he fell. He went out of the way. Hallelujah. Todiah. It says, to guard the way of the tree of life. And what is this tree of life? It's Yah's almighty Torah. That is this tree of life, goodness of Yah. That's this tree of life. That's the only way we're going to make it. Is that we guard this word. We don't compromise it with mom or sister or children. We guard this word. We stand as a defense, like hope. That's what we do. And I'm not buying that. That's not in this book. Show me what's in this book. We guard it. It's real unto us. Hallelujah. We guard it. Hallelujah. What is the way? What do we mean by the words the way? Hallelujah. Even the wicked know the way. Hallelujah. They know they see something that they can't put their hand on. They can't figure it out. They know it's something different. They know it's real. Even those that started out in this way, even as we see them in the marketplace, they're ashamed. They know that there's something right about this. They know that it's right. They know that it's real. They know. What is this way? It says in Matthew 22 and 15, and I'm going to read 16 also. It says, then with the Pharisees and took counsel how they might entangle Yahshua in his talk. And they went out to Yahshua, their disciples, with the Herodians, saying, Rabbi, we know, listen to this, it says, we know that thou art true, and teach the way of Yah in truth. So they knew. That teach the way of Yah in truth. Neither care you for any man, for you regard not the person of men. Hallelujah. That's how you know you're getting the truth. Because it comes back and cuts you. There's no respect to person. There's no regard. Hallelujah. It's the same. Hallelujah. It's the same. They knew. Because it cuts. The way cuts. Hallelujah. It has no respect. And how do we know when we get in the way? Because when you're in the way, you cannot err. You can't err when you're in the way. Hallelujah. I'm going to read wisdom. A lot of you may not have this, but I'm going to read it anyway. Just listen. Wisdom 5 through 7. It says, then shall the righteous man stand, the Kodesh man stand, in great boldness and confidence before the face of those who have afflicted him and made no account of his labors. When they see it, they shall be troubled with terrible fear and shall be amazed at the strangeness of his Yeshua. So far beyond all that they look for, and they repenting and groaning for anguish of Ruah shall say within themselves, this was he whom we have sometime in derision, a proverb of reproach. And it says, we fools accounted his life madness and his end to be without honor. Is that not how they look at the people of Yah today? As fools. It doesn't take all that. That's how they look at us. That's how they come against the people of Yah. This is what this account is talking about. Hold on. And it says, how is he numbered among the children of Yah? This is what it's coming to. And why is his lot among the Kedushim, the saints? As I said earlier, there is a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof is just turmoil, it's destruction, it's hell. Hallelujah. I'm going to read. Therefore have we erred from the way of truth. Have we as a people, have we erred from the way of truth? Hallelujah. Does not this Torah show us what we have erred away from the truth? Yes, it does, Kedushim of Yah. It shows me. Have we erred from the way of truth, and the light of Kodeshness did not shine on us, and the sun of Kodeshness not rise upon us? Wisdom 5 and 7 say, we wearied ourselves in the way of Torahlessness and destruction. Yes, we have gone through trackless deserts. Because Torah says the steps of a Kodesh one are ordered by Yah. So when we're not in the way, we're just making tracks. We're standing in place. There is no growth. There's nothing. Hallelujah. There's no Hava. There's nothing. We don't grow at all. We're still the same we was when we first claimed that we came to Yah. Hallelujah. This book is going to show us what we miss it as in the way. It says, yes, we have gone through trackless deserts where there lay no way. But as for the way of Yah, we have not known. We have not known the way of Yah. Hallelujah. Because we have erred in the way. We have erred in the way of Yah. Because we don't know him. That's why we're sometimes up. We're sometimes down. Hallelujah. But how do we as a people, how do we get in the way? How do we get in the way as a people of Yah? It's simple, conditions of Yah. Marcus 10 and 47, I'm going to read down to 52. It says, and when he heard, this is Barnabas, when his healing, Barnabas' healing, it says, and when he had heard that it was Yahshua of Nazareth, he began to cry. Hallelujah. Do we not hear that this is Almighty Yah? Are we beginning to cry out unto Yah? Yah, help us. Help me, Yah. I need you. I need you, Yah. Hallelujah. He said, Barnabas began to cry. Say, he began to cry. And it says, and say, Yeshua, you, son of David, have kindness on me. Is he not repenting? He said, have kindness on me. He says, and many charged him that he should hold his silence. Yes. Do they not say that today? Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. As I said earlier, it don't take all that. You ain't got to praise him and dance before him. Right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You don't have to do that. That's what they say. Right. But it's right here in the book. It says, and many charged him that he should hold his silence. Yes. But he cried the more. Hallelujah. He cried the more a great deal. You son of David. Hallelujah. He said, you son of David. Have kindness on me. Hallelujah. Have kindness on me. And Yeshua. And look at what this does. Look at what it done to Yeshua. It says, I'm going to read it right here. It says, and Yeshua, he stood still. He knew the desire of the man's heart. He knew his ruah. It made him stand still. Who is that crying out for me? Is this my people? Who is it crying out for me? Who is this crying out for me? He said he stood still. It made Yeshua stand still. Why? Because of the crying. And that's what we must do as a people of Yah. We must cry out unto Almighty Yah. Help me, Almighty Yah. I need you, Yah. That's what we must do as a people. He stood still. Yah heard his cry. Yeshua heard his cry. He stood still. Hallelujah. And he says, who is this? Who is this one? Who is this calling out unto me? Who is this that has a desire? Hallelujah. Who is this that want to do right? Who is this that want to be healed? Who is this that want the healing of Almighty Yah? Who is this? Hallelujah. He says in Yeshua, and he stood still, and he commanded him to be called. Say, bring him up. Where is he? Who is that? Bring him to me. He stood still. He waited. And it says, and they called the blind man. Y'all don't hear me. He say, they called the blind man, saying to him, be of tough comfort. Hallelujah. Are we not blind today? We think we see. We think we know. We don't know nothing. We're blind. We're blind people today. We're moody. Hallelujah. We're sometime up and sometime down. We think we know, y'all. We don't know our Abba. We don't know him. It says, be of tough comfort. Hallelujah. Rise. He calls you. Hallelujah. Call me, Almighty Yah. It says, rise. He calls you. Hallelujah. And it says, and he. This is what we must do. It says, and he. Casting off his garments. In this way. That's what that straight razor would do. Cast off these old garments. It cuts that stuff away. Hallelujah. It cuts it away. That we may walk clean before Yah. Upright, with strength. Hallelujah. We may walk that way. It cuts off those old ways. My grand youngins. Hallelujah. My youngins. My brother. My sister. It cuts it off. My pity-minded ways. It cuts that off. That we may walk upright. That we may be a true condition of Yah. That we may have one the other. Hallelujah. It cuts it off. It makes us be able to walk upright. Hallelujah. That's what it does. Say what you will of me. If we abide in this way, we abide in this book. Hallelujah. That's what it does for the people of Yah. What more else could you want? What is there out there? What more can you want as a people? But this true word. But this Torah of Yah. That's all I want. I don't need nothing else. I don't need nothing else. Hallelujah. Yah will provide all. He will do all. We must stand in this way. We must walk in this way. Wait on Yah. I don't care how hard it seems. Well, I can't do this. Wait on Yah. Get some desire. Be true within your heart. Be true within your lair. I can't do this. I got this problem. I got that problem. Put it in Yah's hand. Be real with Yah. He'll help you. If you want help, if you want help to be sincere, if you're sincere, he'll do it for you. If your heart is sincere, he'll do it. But we do good for a while and we fall right back to the same thing because you wasn't real in the first place. He'll do it if you're sincere. He'll help you. I don't care what it is. He'll help you. That's what his book says. He'll help you. That's the way of Yah. Relying on him. Let me go on. It says, and Yeshua said to him, go in your way. He knew his ruach. He says, go in your way. He says, go in your way. That's what he told him. He says, go in your way. Listen to this. It says, your emunah, your faith has made you whole. Hallelujah. Your emunah, your faith has made you whole. And that's what I want today. And we all should desire that. That type of emunah, to be made whole, to stay in the way, to walk in the way. It's easy to go back. Anybody can do that. But it takes an emunah, a sincerity, to stand, to continue to walk in the way and say, no, I'm not going to go that way. I'm going to follow my Abba. I'm going to walk within this Torah. I'm going to walk within these commandments. I'm going to walk in these mitzvahs. That takes something there. Do you hear me? That takes something. For Yah says, for my yoke is easy. And what we're going through, I wouldn't even call it a yoke. That's the word they want to use. I wouldn't even call it a yoke. Because we leave it all in Yah's hands. It's not a yoke. It's not even a burden. Because Yah says, I got it. You just obey my word. You just walk in my way. That's what he says. That's what he says. It's only going to be a few. It's only going to be a few. People don't like the truth. They don't want to hear truth. And most of all, you know what they don't want to hear? The truth about themselves. They don't want to hear the truth about themselves. Hallelujah. That's what we don't want to hear as the people of Yah. Don't tell me about me. Let's talk about someone else. Don't say nothing about me. And that's how we are. Hallelujah. But we must continue in this way, Kedusha of Yah. Hallelujah. And he... Your faith has made you whole. And immediately, do we hear this? He says, immediately. It says, immediately, he received his sight and followed Yahshua in the way. Hallelujah. Immediately, he received his sight and followed Yahshua in the way. By Emunah. By faith, by having a solid ruah, that nothing changes. It's solid. This will fall off, but the ruah is solid. My children left, but my ruah is solid. I'm in the way. That's what we must be, in the way. Regardless of what happened, our mindset should be, I'm in the way. I'm following Yah. My wife gone. I'm in the way. Hallelujah. My husband left. I'm in the way. I'm in the way. The way of Almighty Yah. To follow. To obey. To be corrected. To grow. Hallelujah. That's the way. That's the way we need to know as the people of Yah. This is that way. We think we're in the way. This book shows us what kind of way we're in. Hallelujah. I'm going to read here in Barak, the scripture, 3:12, Barak, 1 Barak 3:12 and 3:13. And this is saying how you know that you're in the way. It says, 1 Barak 3:12, you have forsaken the fountain of wisdom. For if you had walked in the way of Yah, you should have dwelled in Shalom forever. And as I said earlier, that's why we don't have Shalom. Because we have forsaken. We have not walked in the way of wisdom. We have not walked in the way of Torah. Hallelujah. We have not abided in Almighty Yah. We have not. Because there's no shalom. Because when you're in the way, you have shalom. Well, this happened, that happened, this is going on. Yah will handle it. Shalom. Yah Barak. You deal with it, you keep it moving. That's shalom. Hallelujah. No, you don't have a hang up. You're not sideways. That's shalom. Because you know your Abba. You are in the way. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is the way that we must know as a people. Because in this way, this is our comfort. This is how we are comforted as a people of Yah. This is how we are comforted of being in the way. This is how we're comforted. I'm going to read a few scriptures here. I'm going to go to John 14, and I'm going to work my way from 1 down through 6. It says, let not your lev be troubled. He said, you believe in Yah, believe also in me. We know the account. We've read it before, but I'm going to read it again. It says, in my Abba's house are many mansions. What is that saying there? Many mansions, abodes, places to comfort, that you can lie, hallelujah, that you can lay down and rest in, a dwelling place. We can dwell in Yah. He is the mansion. It's many mansions. We can just have rest within Almighty Yah because we're in that way. Okay, it says, in my Abba's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. He's preparing a place for us. Hallelujah. We know the count. Hallelujah. And he says, and if I go and prepare a place for you, he says, I will come again and receive you to myself. Hallelujah. That where I am, there you may be also. Do we hear that condition of Yah? He said, where he is, if we continue in this way, there we will be also. He says, where I am, there you will be also. And where I go, you know. And the way you know. But Thomas says to him, Master, we know not where you go. How can we know the way? And Yahshua says unto him, I am the way. As Zakane BenAmmiy said earlier, it's only one way. It's only one. And Yahshua says, I am the way, for we must come through him. He says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. He says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. This is not life today, conditions of Yah. They're sickly. They're on medications. 34 and 35 years old, taking blood pills. Come on. That's crazy. Blood medication. This food is killing them. This is not life today. This is life right here, this Torah. You look at those that we see. We've seen those, how they look. Be honest with yourself. I've seen them. This is life. This is the guide right here. This is the way. This book. This is the way. This is life. That's not life out there. And it says, and the life. No man comes to the Abba but by me. Hallelujah. I'm going to read a count here in Acts as Kepha addresses the Yahudims. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Acts 2 and 25. I'm going to read down to 28. For David speaks concerning him. He says, I saw Yahweh always before my face, for he is on my right hand, and I should not be moved. Therefore did my lev rejoice, and my tongue was glad. Moreover, also my flesh shall rest in tikvah. It says, because you will not leave my nephesh in Sheol, neither will you suffer your kodesh one to see corruption. And Yah will not. If we stay in the way, he's not going to suffer us to see corruption. Hallelujah. He's going to do exactly what his word says. This life is but a vapor. You look at how fast time is going. Hallelujah. One minute you're young, next minute you're old. Hallelujah. What is there to sell your nephesh for? Hallelujah. It says, Acts 2 and 27, it says, because you will not leave my nephesh in Sheol, neither will you suffer your Kodesh, one, to see corruption. And it says, you have made known to me the ways of life. You shall make me full of joy with your countenance. Can you not tell when one is in the way? You see the full of that joy in their countenance. Hallelujah. You see that joy. You know. And that's one's facial expression. It shows what's truly in us. Hallelujah. If it's the joy of Yah, or is it the joy of a biscuit? The joy of a plate. Hallelujah. That's what it shows. Hallelujah. Do we get happy when we hear the word of Yah? Or when we're with one the other, just to fellowship? Hallelujah. Or do we get happy when it's time for a biscuit? Hallelujah. And I want to say it just like that. Time for a biscuit. Hallelujah. That's what it says. That you have made known to me the ways of life. You shall make full of joy with your countenance. The countenance of Almighty Yah. When we stay in this way, that's what we will have. The true countenance of Almighty Yah. The joy. Hallelujah. The hava. The family orientation of wanting to be with one the other. Want to pile up on the van. Go here. Do this. A family orientation. You don't see that anymore today. You don't see it. Because we have gotten in the way of the world. Hallelujah. We've gone back to the way of the world. I don't want to do this because it's foolishness. We need to get back to this way. The way Yah intended for us people to be. Hallelujah. Having our mind steadfast upon him. His way. What we need to do to see ourselves as a people. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Totally Yah. Sirach 8 and 15, those of you that may have this, I'm going to read this one scripture, a way that we should not go. Sirach 8 and 15, it says, do not travel by the way with the proud, food-hearted, hardy fellow, lest he be burdensome. And I know what we think, our kinsmen and those that don't know Yah. No. For this proud and food-hearted fellow is within us as a people. That's your proud and food-hearted ways. Hallelujah. That's what we don't want to walk with. That's not in the way. We need to get rid of that. It says, do not travel by the way with the proud, food-heartedly fellow, lest he be burdensome. And we know, if we're honest with ourselves, when we got an alt, or we got this kind of way about us, we know that it's burdensome. It drowns out the Ruah of Almighty Yah, because we want to hold on to that trash. Hallelujah. Instead of just saying, I'm silly, let me get this out of here. Let me do right by my ark, my hope. Huh? That's how we are as a people. That is the burdensome. That's not in the way of Yah. It says the burdensome to you, for he will act according to his own. Will as he pleases. And through his folly, you will perish with him. We will perish with that foolishness within us. We will as a people. If we don't get it out and get in this way of Almighty Yah, that's what we must do. We must get in the way. In the way. Then this is the way. The book is showing us the way. This is not something I'm saying. I didn't conjure this up. I'm just a mere man. I can't even think like this. That's why I need this way. And we need this way as a people of Yah. We need it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. We must get back to the way. As we've heard it saying, we must get back to the old time way. Yes, as we've heard Raah astound on that, yes. The 60s and how families was oriented. Miss Betsy whoop your hips. And when she get done with you, Miss Chlorine whoop your hips. Hallelujah. It took a neighborhood to raise a child. Hallelujah. And that's what we as a people, we must get back to those old time ways. The simple, plain ways of Almighty Yah. But this is a common man's salvation. Simple and plain. But we get so spiritual and so enlightened. Oh, we heard from Yah and we forget about the simple, plain things of Yah. And we complicate it. It's simple. We need to get the basics right first. The basic things. The basic Ahava. Hallelujah. The true Ahava. The realness. Hallelujah. But we're so concerned with it, with ourselves. Hallelujah. And we must get back to the ways of Yah. I'm going to read here in YarameYah 6 and 15 and 6 and 16. Hallelujah. I told y'all for this day. Hallelujah. Another day that I may come and hear his truth. Because this is for me today. I need this. For I'm happy that he has allowed us together. Together, together, to hear the word of truth. Hallelujah. That way that we may grab something to take us on to the next time that we meet. Hallelujah. I need it. You all can play if you want. I know what I need. I know what I need. I need this. Hallelujah. I need it. Jeremiah 6:15. It says, "Well, were they? Was Israel ashamed when they had committed abominations?" No. It says, "Nay, they were not at all ashamed." Are we ashamed today because of Yah? Do we hear this word and does it make us ashamed to what we want to do right? We want to get in the way. It does me. I want to get in the way. I want to be right. I want him to come back for me. And we should all have that desire. Hallelujah. Neither could they blush. Wow. Therefore, they shall fall among them that fall. At that time that I visit them, they shall be cast down, saith Yahweh. Jeremiah 6 and 16 says, "Thus said Yah." And this is what we need to do as the people of Yah. It says, "Thus saith Yah, stand you in the ways." Stand in the ways, condition of Yah. Let's not stand in the way. Not in our way. But stand in the way of Yah. It says, "And see and ask for the old." Yeah. We got to get back to the old time way. It says, "And the old pathways." Yeah. Where is the tough way? Sure is. The old time way. Praying, fasting, hallelujah, the old time way, bending our knees, hallelujah, seeking out one the other, the old time ways, to sit around and have that camaraderie, hallelujah, the true fellowship, hallelujah, and walk therein. It says the old, it says, ask for the old pathways, ask for the old pathway, where is the tough way, and walk therein. And it says, and you shall find rest for your nephesh. The old time way. We've gotten so spiritual. We need to get back to the old time ways. That's what the book says. But they said, we will not walk therein. Hallelujah. We think we're above this book. We got to get back in this way, conditions of y'all. We got to get back. We got to get back to this way. This is the only way that we're going to make it. This is the only way. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
But we as a people, we want to charge Yah. And we can't do that. It's because of him. It's because of them. Because I did. No. We can't charge Yah. And we should never charge y'all with that lie. We should never do it. Right here, I'm going to read Sirach 11 and 15. It says, "Wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of Torah are of Yah. Love and the way of Tov works are from him." All this comes from Yah. That's what it is. All that comes from Yah. Wisdom, it says wisdom, knowledge, understanding, This is the way that is from Yah. It says, Sirach 15:11. This is what I supposed to read. I'm sorry. Here it is. Don't ever charge Yah with this lie. It says, 15:11 say, don't say, because of Yahweh, I left the right way. Hallelujah. For you ought not to do things that he hate. So he'll allow that spirit to overtake you, to drive you on out. We can't blame Yah. And that's what we do as a people. We'll blame Yah. Well, because of this, this is what happened. No. That's not being in the way. You still respond right. You still do right, regardless. Hallelujah. You still do right. That's long-suffering. Torah tells us that all that lies within us, what? Live peaceably with every man. And it says, especially they of the house of Emunah. So we can't charge y'all for anything. Hallelujah. We don't get by with that. The ways of Yah. Psalms 138:21. It says, I will worship toward your Kodesh great tabernacle and use your name for your steadfast loving kindness and for your truth. You have magnified your word and your name above all. As BenAmmiy said, there's one. There ain't but one name. There ain't but one way. And this is the way. It says, 138:3, Psalms. It says, in the day when I cried, you answered. He will answer. You answered me. And strengthened me with strength in my nephesh. That's the only thing that we as a people, if we just can just wait upon Yah, be patient, he will come through. But we get impatient. It says, and strengthen me in my nephesh. It says, 138:4, it says, all things of the earth shall praise you, Almighty Yah, when they hear the words of your mouth. In Psalms 138:5, it says, yes, they shall sing in the ways of Yah. For great is the splendor of Yah. Hallelujah. Great is the splendor of Almighty Yah. And when we are in the way, hallelujah, there shall be a joy, a countenance. Where we can get up and dance. We can sing. We're not worried about who's looking, how to dance look. We're just going to dance for Yah. We're just going to get, we're in the way. It doesn't matter. We're in the way. Hallelujah. This is how we know we're in the way of Almighty Yah. We put off that, as Barnabas, if put off that old and put on this new. Well, we can dance before Yah. It's a splendor. Hallelujah. And we're happy. We don't have a complaint about nothing. Happy before Almighty Yah. Glad to know him. Hallelujah. Happy to know him. Not with a long face. Not because our stomachs are growling. But we are eating on the things of Yah. Hallelujah. And that surpasses that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're happy to hear the word of Yah. We're so happy. We're wound up in it. We're not thinking about a plate. We're not thinking about no food. We're thinking about the word of Yah. And even after this is over, it takes you a while to calm down because you're so worked up with the things of Yah. His emunah is just churning within you. It's churning within your mind. It's churning within your nephews, within your lab. Hallelujah. It takes you a while just to calm down and say, okay, I'm ready to eat now. Hallelujah. And that's how we should be. That's when you know you're in the way. Hallelujah. That's when you know you're in the way. It works you up. Like, come on, man, preach. Tell me some more. Let me hear some more. Hallelujah. That's how you know you're in the way of Yah. Hallelujah. It says, 1 Barak 2:33, it says, It says, how do I get back to the way? How do we get back? This is the answer here. How do we get back? Yeah, we've fallen short. I know I have. We've fallen short. We need to get back into the way of Yah. As BenAmmiy says, so we may continue. As our King told us, that we may continue. But we must get back to the way to continue. Hallelujah. It says, Barak 2 and 33. And return from their stiff neck and from their wicked deeds. For they shall remember the way of their fathers. So we must return. We must put off those things that has creeped in. Hallelujah. The things that have creeped in. And Satan is going to do his job. He's going to do his job. That's why, as we heard, we must stay on guard, people of Yah. We must guard the word of Yah. We must stay on guard because he's going to creep in. He's going to do his job. But that don't mean we surrender unto him. We get back. We bounce back. We stay in the way. Hallelujah. That's what we must do. We must stay in the way. The way of Almighty Yah. Hallelujah. And that doesn't give us an excuse to do wrong. It doesn't give us an excuse now. But we must press. You slip. Oh, Yah knows we don't get by. We can do that if we want and think we're getting by. Oh, yeah, well. No, that's not the way it goes. If your desire is sincere and you're sincere, you're pressing. Oh, I messed up. But it was honest, and Yah knows he sees all. You understand? That's being in the way. Not using that as an excuse to do wrong. Hallelujah. That's being in the way. You didn't intend to do that. You didn't conjure it. Hallelujah. You didn't plan it. You wasn't looking to do it. Hallelujah. That's being in the way. That's walking in the way. And in that way, you can continue. Hallelujah. You can continue. Because Yah knew your love was sincere. He knew your desire. Hallelujah. That way you can continue in the things of Yah. Proverbs 6 and 23, it says, for the commandment is a lamp, and the Torah is the light, and reproof. That's the key word, reproof. We don't want to be instructed. We got to get in the way that when we're instructed, we take it to heart, and we begin to work on that thing, that we may grow. That's being in the way. That's being in the way. When you're instructed, you take it to heart. And it bothers you to where you get up on your knees about it. You say, Yah, help me. I don't want to be this way. I don't want to be this way, Yah. This is wrong. I don't want to shame you this way. You've given me a chance to inherit the kingdom. You didn't have to choose me, but you did. You've given me a way. You've chose me. Hallelujah. And this is what I think of you. I take it for granted? No, we must take reproof to heart. We must wrestle with it and get it right. Hallelujah. We must. That's being in the way. That's real. Hallelujah. But we say we know Yah. We say we're the people of Yah. Hallelujah. Yah has a people. Are we in this way? Are we his people today? Are we Yah's people? Hallelujah. Of course we are. Hallelujah. For the commandment is a lamp and the Torah is a light, and reproof of instructions are the way of life. Reproof and instructions are the way of life. And reproof and instructions are the way of Almighty Yah. And proof and instruction is the way of serving Yah. And proof and instructions is the way to Yah. For Yah is the way. Hallelujah. Yah is the way. Yahweh. He is the way. Hallelujah. Yah is the way. And this is the way that we must abide in as the people of Yah. Hallelujah. Totally Yah. And that's what we need, people of Yah. We need this book. We need it. I know I need it. And I am amongst the people of Yah. I am a op. So I'm in this boat with you all. And those of you that are listening, that are sincere. Hallelujah. Those of you that are real, those of you that have a heart to please y'all, and it bothers you when you're corrected because you want to stay in the way, you want to be in the way. Hallelujah. For y'all is the way. And let us stay in the way. Let us stay in the way, Kadosh of y'all. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm not going to try to finish this. There's two more pages, Zakane. So, Zakane, YarameYah. Hallelujah. Right. Hallelujah. 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 Let us praise him, Kadosh. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. As far as I'm concerned on that one, he could have continued that one on out. We do brought Yahweh for all things, hallelujah. For the message, the wonderful meal he has presented unto us by Zakane, BenAmmiy, Abash, and our ox Shimriy, that we continue in this way, and not only that, but concerning the path that we must go in, we must walk in, Yisrael. You know, something even we as a people and as a nation, as we heard our ox Shimriy say, we don't want to be instructed. We don't want to be told what to do. Even when we know, we don't understand the way or the path. For some reason in our mind, we don't want to be perceived that we don't know, we don't understand Yisrael. That's why Yahweh, he places those in our lives. He places situations and circumstance that we turn unto him. Not our own way, not our own path, or what I think needs to be done, but his way. As we heard, he is the way. And there's only one way, and that is through Yahshua HaMashiach, his mitzvah, his Torah. Hallelujah. We have heard our Akim express this path, this instructing us in this way how we must go, Yisrael. And they have opened their lips unto us. They have cried out. They have opened Torah. And they have opened scripture to us. So I'm just going to read just a few more things as we bring this to a close. We have a few more minutes, Yisrael, that we understand how Yahweh operates and what he is doing, as we have heard. Because Yahkahana, he done the same thing in his responsibilities as he cried out to make our crooked path straight, and to return unto Almighty Yahweh, because he is, as we heard our ox say, the only way. Hallelujah. So let me read this here. Just a few testimonies unto this, what we have heard today. Starting right here in Matthew chapter 3. Just a few scriptures. The Torah said that in those days came Yahkahanan, as he immersed, preaching in the wilderness of Judea, and saying, repent ye. Did we not hear that? Our Akshemi told us that we must get back in this way, the old path, the old way. Don't know if we're going to do that, Yisrael. We must repent before Almighty Yahweh. He says, repent you, for the Melchut, the kingdom of Yahweh, it is at hand. He said, for this is that which was spoken by the prophet Isaiah, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, what? To prepare you the way of Almighty Yahweh and make his paths straight. Did not our king express that unto us, Zakane? That we must continue. We must make even the crooked paths, as we heard our ox Shimriy. We make a mistake. We don't fall or use that for an excuse. We get up and we continue, Yisrael. That's what we should do. We must make this crooked path straight. And again in Mark chapter 1, it says, in the beginning of the message of Yahshua HaMashiach, the son of Almighty Yahweh, as it is written concerning the Nabis in the prophet, the book, behold, I send my messenger before my face. And he has sent his Malach, our king, before the face of Yisrael today. He said, I send my messenger before my face, which shall prepare the way before you. Have not Yahshua HaMashiach prepared the way? Have not our king showed us the path and have prepared themselves that they may instruct us concerning this way and this path? And again, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare you the way of Yahweh and make his paths straight. We must make our path straight, Israel, y'all, this way, this walk. Many times we want to veer to the left or to the right, thinking that there's a shortcut, there's an easier way. There's a path that suits me better. It's not so rough on the feet. There's not so many obstacles in the way. And we turn out of this straight and narrow path, Israel, y'all. There's no other way. We cannot continue to turn. We cannot continue to seek those things that are not written in Torah, that are not Almighty Yahweh. But we must continue in these paths as we have heard today. Again, in Lucas, as we bring this to a close, this wonderful time, we have gathered to eat the wonderful words, the wonderful message that have been sent for us from HaShemayim by fire. It says here in Lucas chapter 3, I just want to start here at verse 3. And it came into all the country around Jordan, preaching the immersing of repentance before Almighty Yahweh of sins. We heard that, Yisrael Yah, confessing our sins, repenting before Almighty Yahweh, making this crooked path straight, getting our minds straight, Yisrael Yah, our priorities in line concerning Torah. He said, repentance and the remissions of sin, verse 4, as it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah the prophet, saying, the voice of Isaiah the prophet crying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, what? Again, to prepare the way of Almighty Yahweh and to make his paths straight. So we heard from our king today what we should do, the process of that, the path, and continuing in this way, continuing in those things that have been laid, the foundation, the stone, Yahshua HaMashiach, and continuing in those ways. Though we may fall, though we may stagger, we get back up and we continue. We press. We endure. We send our prayers unto Almighty Yahweh for each and every one of us. To each and every one of us, as we heard, we do tov unto all men, but especially those of the Beit Kol Yisrael. We must do tov unto one another, Yisrael. We must encourage one another to stay in the path. We must encourage one another to be sober and vigilant, that we may continue in the way, the straight and narrow path that Yahweh intends for us, Yisrael. Why do you think he has laid instructions for us? Because there is a path, there's a way he desires us to walk in that leads unto the Melkut, the kingdom, that draws us closer unto him, Abba Yisrael, closer unto Abba Yahweh, for our benefit, that we may grow, that we may multiply, that the riches of the HaShemayim may be poured out upon all Yisrael. Because we are a people, we are strong, we are mighty in Yahshua HaMashiach. We have all the riches of the Melkut, the kingdom, but we must continue in this path. We must, as I recall my father saying, and he will quote this many times, that we may continue to see what the end is going to be. Those latter times and the latter days, Yisrael Yah, that we may meet that path and get to the end of that race, to the finish line. Hallelujah, as we see Yahshua HaMashiach face to face, and as we continue in this path this way, Yisrael Yah. Wasn't this not an enlightening time for us, Yisrael Yah, as we gathered in Yerushalayim? Hallelujah. Those that are listening by Viv live stream, I'm not going to desire, but I know that your Levin was Barak, that it was blessed, that it was enlightened today, that your palate, your bellies are full with the fatness of the message that was preached unto us by our King. And as I came, that we may continue, Yisrael Yah. Not to give up, not to give in, but to continue in the path of Siddiq of righteousness and Yahshua HaMashiach. So let us stand to our feet. Let us continue to give Todah unto Almighty Yahweh. For as we have heard, he knows what we have need of, Yisrael. Hallelujah. He has given us the book. He has given us our king. He has given us the Nabi that we may continue in those ways, Yisrael, in Yahshua HaMashiach. Almighty Yahweh, we do barak you for this time, this occasion. You have allowed us, Abba Yahweh. You have given us breath, Abba Yahweh, to gather together. Those are listening by via live stream. Those are listening by the radio broadcast from here, Teshua community. And those that have gathered here in Teshua community with like-mindedness of Emunah, desire and seeking, Abba Yahweh, those things that will continue and impel us in this path, Abba Yahweh, that you have laid out for us in Yahshua HaMashiach. And you have made this path, this way, plain and simple. And all you have asked of us, Abba Yahweh, is to continue, Abba Yahweh. We told you, Abba Yahweh. We barak you, Abba Yahweh. We told you for sitting the bread from Shemayim upon us, Abba Yahweh, to feed us this day. And we do ask those that have gathered, those that have traveled far and near to gather with Kol Yisrael, Yah, that you return them, Abba Yahweh, to that place of inhabitation until the next time we gather together. And in all things we do, Baraki, we give you Todah. In the precious and mighty name of Yahshua HaMashiach, we do pray. Hallelujah. 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 Shabbat shalom, Kol Yisrael, Yah. Shabbat shalom. Hallelujah.